Yesterday we have started with JDBC and we have will go for 1 minute revision that what we'll be covering into this chapter. So we'll be talking about the architecture, the different APIs, the types of drivers being used and the steps for creating a JDBC application. Then we'll go into detail about the types of statement, same way types of result set, and we'll go for some operation that is create retrieve, update and delete, that is CRUD operations of JDBC, and finally we land up with what is meaning of a connection pooling. So basically this is actually the skeleton of this chapter. Now yesterday we have seen how this architecture is been designed as far as this diagrammatic representation is concerned. The application is getting integrated with the different types of databases for which it will be taking help of the JDBC API. And into that is a JDBC driver manager that will be specifying which type of drivers from the concerned database need to be get connected. So your Java application will get connected to your database only with the help of your JDBC API, and the manager, that is a driver manager, will be responsible for connecting to a specific set of drivers of your concerned database. Now we have seen what all components were there required whenever we go for JDBC. So major thing is that is we need a driver manager, because that is one thing that will be connecting your Java application with a database. There is a driver that will be provided by your service provider. So whichever database you are using, they will be providing you the driver, so you will be using that one. And the APIs, that is Java API, different types of classes and interfaces required for the purpose of connectivity. So there is one connection class which will be getting connected to a concerned database. A statement to execute your SQL query, and the result set is nothing but a buffer for retrieving. The retrieved data is being maintained, or it is being stored in a what you call as a temporary file, that is nothing but your result set. And whenever we are doing some operation, surely that will be handled. We need to be creating some types of exception, so there is a separate set of exception being tackled by your SQL, that is nothing but your SQL exception. So we need to handle this exception as and when required when we go for the connectivity with the database. Now yesterday we have started with the types of drivers. So basically we talk with a name called as a type 1, type 2, type 3 and type 4. So based upon your scenario, which type of drivers is recommended is up to you. Now the type 1 driver we have talked yesterday about, that was JDBC ODBC bridge driver. But from version 1.7 onward, this type of driver is not been used, not been supported by Java. So you cannot use this driver nowadays. Now second one is JDBC native API driver, where APIs will be created using C or C++ programming language. And there is one called as Oracle Call Interface, that is OCI. This is one of the database driver that will be supporting this type of what we call as driver, that is JDBC native API driver. Now we have yesterday talked about the third type of driver, which is mainly be recommended. So we'll be having an example on the same thing, that is JDBC net pure driver, Java driver. Where we'll be using different the Java APIs will be interacting with application and your driver, and it is very efficient as far as the connectivity of database is concerned. So this is the third type of driver, and fourth, that is majorly going into a company that will be hiring database separately from a company like IBM or Sybase or Oracle. So type 4 driver is not that much useful when the people are going in a small companies, but when it is going for the huge companies, that is MNC, CMM level 5 companies, then at that situation the fourth type of driver, that is a pure Java driver, is being used. So this is native pure Java, and it is 100% pure Java. So there is a difference between native pure, because it here you can, it is a flexible, you can add any database at runtime. So the little bit change and you can connect, you can disconnect that database, and you can reconnect another type of database. So that is not possible in pure Java, because pure, this is the fourth type of driver that will recommend only a specific database only. So yesterday we have landed up with this. Now we'll be today, we'll continue how to create a JDBC application and what all the things are required. So it is a five-step operation. Only five steps you have to carry out whenever you are connecting to the database. Now step number one, you have to register your driver first. So step number one, we'll be doing a registration of driver. What and how it has been done, that we'll be having a practical demonstration of that. Second one is after the driver has been registered, the second thing is that you have to go for connecting that with the database. So you have to write something to get connected to the database. So there are some classes and interfaces required to get connected to the database. Third one, you need to execute a query on that database. So that is create statement. And when you execute a query, you need to follow some operations, that is execute query or update query or whatever actions you want to do on your database. So that is the fourth step you are doing. And lastly, finally, whenever your task is completed, it is your duty that you need to close the connection with your database. So these are the basic five things you have to keep in mind whenever you will be going for the database connectivity. That is the register a driver, get connected, create statement, execute query, and close the statement. So we'll talk about how this to register the database. Now for registering a database, what we need is one type of function called the forName. Now this is a forName function that will be helping us to get connected to your concerned database. So what type of driver you want to use, whether you want to use a type 1, type 2, type 3, or type 4, that everything is been formulated by the function called as a forName. So which type of driver you want to use? So this class is called as a static, what we call as a function. This is a function of static class. So the name of the class is class. Itself is called it as a class. So here, when I want to get connected to the type 1 driver, I will be writing, that is Microsoft Access, I will be writing class.forName sun.jdbc.odbc.jdbc.odbc driver. Now this is a type 1 driver. Now if I want to get connected to the Oracle type of database, that is type 3 or type 4, anyone, at that situation I need to use a string called as oracle.jdbc.driver.oracle-driver. And whenever I want to get connected to my SQL, so it is com.mysql.jdbc.driver. So now these are the four types of string, three types of string you can use concerned on your database. So for Microsoft, for Oracle and MySQL, it is a choice of the developer, so which type of database you want to use. Now I want to inform you that from version 1.7 onwards, the Microsoft drivers are not been supported by the Java application. From version 1.7. Am I audible to everyone? Yes?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so you have till date you have learned that you will be connecting to the database called as Microsoft, but from version 1.7 onwards, and now we are using 1.8, you cannot use this, that is class.forNameSun.jdbc. Now you can either use a database called as Oracle or you can use a database like MySQL. So for that purpose, I have put a string over here because this is the first thing that you have to register a driver, and if it is registered, then only you can move further for your database connectivity. The syntax is very simple. That is, you are using forName, and whenever you are using this forName, that is a forName, whenever you are writing this syntax in your program, 100% one type of exception is been thrown, that is class not found exception. So you have to keep in mind, whenever you are using class.forName, there is one type of exception that you have to follow. It is somewhat different. The name of the exception is class not found exception, and you have to handle this exception whenever you are using this function. Because basically whenever you are getting connected to a database, it is not allowing for your Java to get connected. So this is you have to tackle at the initial stage only. Now step number two, that is after getting what we call as after registering to the driver, you need to do a connection. The name of function is get connection. Now the name of function is get connection. Just previously it was forName, it is now here it is get connection. Now this connection class is from a driver manager. So again, it is a static class, so you will be using directly, that is driver manager dot get connection. So driver manager, that is driver manager, it is part of connection, so we'll be using get connection function. And whenever you are using this get connection function, one type of exception is been thrown, that is SQL exception. So whenever you are using this one, you have to follow this one. Now it is single parameter and it is multi-parameter. Single parameter means what? It will be having only one path, that is in double quoted. In some cases, it is what we call as an path of your database and with some username and password. So basically, when we go for Oracle or for MySQL, at that situation, your system is with some username and data passwords. So you have to provide that username and password, then only it will be opened as and when required. But when you go for Access, because it is open source, so there is no chance of you having a username and password. At that situation, you can use this type of function, that is only get function with that URL. So I have given these three type of examples over here. Whenever you want to get connected that is using a get connection function to MySQL, access database, you will be using a function called as JDBC colon ODBC colon MyDSN. Now this DSN you have to create using administrative tool. I will show you how this DSN will be created, but you will be creating a DSN of your database, and that will be provided within a double quoted to this function called as get connection, and this is from a class called as a driver manager. So driver manager dot get connection, and automatically you will get a connection object ready for a database connectivity. Same way, when you want to get connected to the Oracle database, so JDBC colon Oracle colon thin colon at the rate localhost colon 1512 colon XE. XE is the name of a database. Then username called as system and whatever password you have given. Now here I will be dealing you, teaching you with the helping of MySQL database, because it is open source, so you can use at any moment. So for us, the syntax will be driver manager dot get connection. It is JDBC. It's just same like that. Colon. Here I am Oracle. Here it is MySQL. Colon. Here there is at the rate, here is two forward slashes. Localhost colon, it's a port number of MySQL. It is by default, it is not changing anyway. So you have to give the port number called as 3306. And into that, there my database is available. The name of the database is IBMRD. So slash IBMRD, and I am giving a second parameter with the comma delimiter, that is my root. And by default, MySQL don't have any password. So it is only empty password field that I have provided. So three parameters, just like a previous example. First one is URL, where exactly my database is. Second one, the username of my database. And third one, the password of my database. So these are the three things I have to pass. And you have to keep in mind, you have to mug up the string, because it is only possible if you have the string in your hand, then only you can get connected to your database. So it is JDBC colon, MySQL colon, two forward slash localhost colon, 3306 forward slash and the name of a database. I will show you how this database is being created. In Oracle also it is JDBC colon Oracle colon thin colon at the rate localhost colon 1521 is a port number for Oracle dedicate, and colon, this is name of database. So it is same thing what we'll be using. It is just on the choice of a user which type of database you want to use. Now step number three, whenever you want to execute some query on your database. Now the step number one, you have registered database. Step number two, you are now being connected to database. Now it is a duty which type of operation you want to do, whether you want to go for insert, update or delete, what type of statement. So it is create statement. So this is one you call as a function that will be used with the help of connection. So connection dot create statement, and that statement, whatever you want to throw, you have to provide into a double quote. So whenever you are using the create statement, so there is one exception been thrown by and need to be handled by SQL exception. So it is very simple syntax, that is statement object is being created using connection dot create statement. Okay. This is step number three. And now after the statement is being created, now you, it's a duty of a programmer to execute that query. So here simple execute query. If you are having, you want to retrieve something from a database, that is if the query is select, you will be using a function called as execute query. And if you are going for insert, update and delete, you will be using execute update. So for insert, update and delete, you will be using execute update, and for only select statement, you will be using execute query. Now when you are selecting something, 100% it will be throwing, your database will be retrieving something and it will be sent to your temporary, it will be transferred into your Java program. So for that purpose, result set is required. So result set is another type of what we call as an interface, an object that will help you to have a buffer. And whenever you are executing a select query, this is just like this example, select star from employee. So if there are 10 records, all 10 records will be transmitted to the temporary buffer called as a result set. And using a next function, that is result set dot next function, you can retrieve all the string and all the integers from your concerned result set. So that is also possible. So here you have to use execute query for whenever there is a select statement, and execute update whenever there is an insert, update or delete statements is being followed. But whenever you are using this execute query, you need to handle this exception called as SQL exception. So all and everywhere you have to write a try and catch block. And finally, step number five. Your task is completed. Now finally, what you have to do is that you have to close the connection because the connection needed to be closed whenever your task is completed. So finally, we'll be using the connection that is con.close. And whenever you are closing any connection, there is an SQL exception. You have to handle that exception by using SQL exception. Okay. So these are the five things you have to keep in mind. Now, as far as result set is concerned, as we have talked about, now result statement means what type of statement you want to transmit or you want to throw on your database. So there are different types of statements, that is interface. So as I have previously said, there is execute query and there is execute update. So whenever you are creating an object of statement interface, whenever you are dealing with a select query, whenever you are dealing with a select query, you will select a query, but that will return you result set. Because the database will be providing the record at the after executing that query. So the function is called as execute query, and only select statement is passed in execute query, and as a return, you will be receiving a result set. Same way, whenever you want to do some operation like create, drop, or insert, or update, or delete, so the thing that is nothing but a DML, that is data manipulation you want to do with database. So we'll be using a function called as execute update, and you will be passing your query into that, and it will be showing you the number of records it been affected, whether one record has been inserted or one record is deleted, or how many records that is have been dropped after deleting the dropping the database, or how many records are been updated after updating query is been fired. So there is execute update and execute query of your statement, and these are the basic things you have to keep in mind. Now there is one more thing that is called as an execute function. It is used to execute query that may require multiple result. So if you want to have a multiple results to be get executed, so you can use this function called as execute. And there is whenever you want to do something with a batches, so that for executing a batches, it is called execute batch. So probably for a student like us, it is the only two things you have to keep in mind. That is, one is execute query and execute update. Query only for select function, execute update for insert, update, delete, and all type of functions. So that you have to keep in mind. Now you can transmit your query in three different ways. One is called as a statement, another is called as a prepared statement, and third one is called as a callable statement. Now you can use any same three types of, these are three types, and it is a choice of a user, a choice of a developer, which type of statement he want to use. Basically, whenever you are dealing with a select query, it is always expected to go for statement. Whenever you are doing with insert, update, and delete type of functionalities with your database, it is always expected for going for prepared statement. And whenever you want to write a stored procedure, that is PLSQL, you are writing a stored procedure, and into that stored procedure you have written some query of insert, update, and delete. So at that situation, you are expected to write a callable statement. So it is a choice of a developer which type of statement he want to use, whether a statement, whether it is a prepared statement or whether it is callable statement. And as far as your syllabus is concerned, we'll be demonstrating two types of statement here, that is statement and a prepared statement. So we'll have an example, multiple level of examples over here at live. And in those situations, we'll be using a statement and prepared statement. Callable statement is not, we'll be not using, because we, for that purpose, we have to write some PL SQL, that is, you have to write some stored procedure for executing that queries. Same way, I want to have a demonstration of this object, that is wherever execute is been used, or whenever execute update is used, and whenever execute query is been used. So whenever you are creating a statement, so statement create object is always created like connection.create statement, and it need to be put it into a try block, and you need to catch those exception using SQL exception. And in a final statement, you need to close the statement also. So whenever you are dealing with the statement in a try and in the catch, you will be catching the problem it has been faced after doing connected with the statement. But make a habit of writing a finally statement where you will be closing those statement as and when required. So prepared statement is another same type of statement. So your statement is only one type of query you'll be providing. But whenever you are dealing with a prepared statement, that is a second type of statement, you will be using some question mark, and you will be providing the values to this question mark at the runtime. Now this is very much flexible. So it is very much flexible. At the runtime, you can do some operations, and you can execute a query with majorly for updation or deletion or a creation of your record. So this is preferably been used for creating, updating, and deleting. And we will be using for prepare statement. You can use execute query and execute update also. So you have to keep in mind whenever you are doing this program. Now the third type, that is a callable statement. Now what is exactly the callable statement is? So basically in Oracle, we are creating a stored procedure like this. So this is a stored procedure. This is one set of functions been written. Employee ID name function, select first into. So here it is one simple program that will be doing a join, and here will be retrieving the record from your employee table. So this is type of stored procedure is been written, and this is being called using a callable statement. The other type of that is after completing a statement, that is after completing these three types of statement, that is a simple statement, a prepared statement, and callable statement, there is a type called as a result set. So whenever you are going for retrieving some record using a select query, you will be getting a record. So that record, it is in a sequential order. You can read it from the top and you can end up with the bottom. Now it is only what we call as forward readable, just like C programming. Whenever we go for C programming, it is always a structured programming. It starts from top and it ends. It is top to bottom approach. Same way, whenever any result set is being created, it is always in the same. It is called as a sequential. It starts reading from the top, and it ends up with bottom. And once your cursor is moved down, it cannot be moved up. So whatever thing you have to do is that you have to make your result set more efficient. So for making it more efficient, you can use some ready-made property, that is type forward only. So this is nothing but you are making a cursor of your result set, that is it will be reading by default. This is type forward only. If you want to scroll, that is you want to retrieve, you want to navigate from first to next, next to previous, last, and all those things, you have to make it type scroll sensitive. And if you don't want your cursor to be moved forward and backward, in those situations you can use a type underscore scroll underscore insensitive. So this is nothing but a property of a result set. So you can use any of this. By default you can use a type forward only. So this is by default for any result set, it is type forward only. But for making it scrollable, you can use any of this, that is type scroll sensitive. That means your cursor will be scrollable. Otherwise, by default it will be type scroll insensitive. This means your result set cursor will not be moved forward and backward. Now there is one more thing, that is concurrency. That there are multiple result sets can be created, and now you want to allow the only one result set. That is, you want to make it read only, or to make it that cursor updatable. So result set ko aapko read only karna hai. So by default it is read only. So you can read only result set. But aapko agar run time mein lag raha hai ki mujhe result set mein kuch changes karne hain, so I can make it, that is concur underscore updatable. This means I can make a cursor. You can make a change in your result set values, and that result set values will be updated as and when required. So the previous one is nothing but a cursor type, and this is nothing but your concurrency type. So three types of what we call as properties are being used for making it making the cursor forward movable, or making it cursor what we call sensible. So scrollable करने के लिए आपको ये तीनों में से कोई भी use कर सकते हैं. And for making it updatable, that is your result set may be dealing with the update. So there is the two property, that is read only and one is updatable. So ये basically use किया जाता है. So whenever you are dealing with any result set, you can use a function called as before first, after last, first function, last function, absolute function, relevant function, previous function, next function, get row, move to the insert row, move to the current row. So first, next, last, previous, ऐसे function जो है आप उसको use करके you can navigate into your result set. जैसे आप database में navigate कर सकते हैं, उसी तरीके से आप एक result set के अंदर भी navigate कर सकते हैं, आप result set को भी update कर सकते हैं. ये आपको ध्यान में रखना है. But one thing you keep in mind, every time there is will be an exception being thrown, that is called as an SQL exception. So before first, यानी आपके इसके पहले क्या है, ये record खत्म हो गया. After last, this is for checking whether the record is completed or not. First, next, previous and last, ये कुछ चार फंक्शन आप basically use कर सकते हैं for navigating. Now, as far as SQL is concerned, now there are different types of operations we'll be doing. That is DML, that is data manipulation language. There is a DDL, that is data definition language, and DCL, that is data control language. ये तीन ही तरीके के languages SQL allow करता है. So for creating any table, I want to create table or I want to delete table directly. So creating and deleting, that is create table employee with some IDs like this and with some parameters like a varchar and all those things. So whenever I am dealing with create statement or a drop statement, I am nothing but I am using a DCL, that is a data control language. But whenever I am dealing with a select query, select queries are only under the category called as DDL, that is data definition language, where only select statement will be used. So select first name, last name from employee where ID is equal to 100. So you can retrieve any record. And whenever you are using DDL, a result set will be used for retrieving and for navigating the database. But when we go for DML, you are using a function called as execute update. Here you will be using execute update. Here you will be using execute query. So insert statement, so insert into, so this is a syntax used for the inserting a record. So insert into employee values, the parameter value 1, 2, and 3, and 4. So we are providing these four values. Whenever I want to do some updation, so update employee set whatever changes you want to set, where a specific what you call as a primary key can be referred, that is where ID is equal to 100. So where keyword is used for the purpose of updation. Same way, I want to delete one specific record, so delete from employee where ID is equal to some specific runtime ID has been provided. So this is nothing but a syntax for insert, a syntax for update, syntax for delete. All these three are from DML, that is data manipulation language. And for DDL, it is select statement for selecting a record. And for DCL, that is data control language, you can use a create statement or you can use a drop. You can delete a table directly also. So drop table, I want to delete a table, so drop table employee. So are you clear with this one? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anyone, any problem as far as statement, result set, and different five steps of database connectivity is concerned? Anyone?
No, sir.
Okay, no problem. So, jana hai aage?
Yes, okay. Sir.
Now, I will show you. There are some prerequisites because मुझे आपको ये बताना है कि Java don't allow from version 1.8. मैं आपको ये Google पे सर्च करके दिखाता हूँ. So अभी मेरे मन से तो मैं नहीं बता रहा, but Java don't support now type 1 type of driver from version 1.8 onwards. Okay. So I will search it on Google and show you in front of you. अगर मैंने ये करने की कोशिश की तो मुझे जावा कभी अलाउ नहीं करेगा बिकॉज माई वर्जन ऑफ जावा इज 1.8, इज अ रिसेंट वर्जन. सो वेदर इट इज हैंग्ड आई थिंक सो, सो लेट इट बी. गूगल it is slowing down because my system is whenever we are on a Google Meet 100% the system is always been locked. Type 1 driver in Java 1.8. Support. So we'll go for tutorial point where it has been written or somewhere. You can search anywhere, you can get an information that from version No, it is not there. So let it be. So you can, I will share you the link. But whenever, now this operation I want to do. So today program will be going for DDL, that is because majorly all the queries are concerned with select statement only. So we'll go for running this query and creating a table. So whenever you are dealing with MySQL, because this is open source, so there is no need for you to do, you pay something for your database. So whenever you are doing something with MySQL, one thing you have to do is that after installing MySQL, you have to download one jar file from your browser, that is mysqlconnector.jar file, and you need to paste it in your jre.lib.ext folder. And this is one way. So two ways are there whenever you are related to your MySQL database, that you have to download this jar file and you have to paste it into your jar file. So I will show you that way also. And second way is that setting a class path. So you can set a class path of your jar file that is present into your MySQL when it has been installed. So you can put a temporary path like this also, so set class path, or you can put permanent class path like this also of your jar file using environment variable that we have already seen, the how this environment variable is seen. But for my sake, I can say that this is a very simple, that you can download this mysqlconnect.jar file directly from your website, and you can paste it on the path code as jar lib and into this text. I will show you how it has been downloaded. And so what you have to do is that you can copy this name, mysqlconnect.jar file, and you will go on a browser, Google, and you paste over there. So whenever you put like this, free download for Java, तो ये आपको एक वेबसाइट की तरफ ले जाएगा. दैट इज द नेम ऑफ द वेबसाइट, इज devmysql.com. इट इज dev, दैट इज डेवलपर mysql.com. ये साइट पे मत जाओ, बिकॉज यहाँ पर बहुत कॉम्प्लिकेटेड करता है करने के लिए. सो देयर विल गो फॉर अनदर वन. सो हियर ऑल्सो इट इज जावा 2s. So you can click here, and when you click on this, it will be downloading some jar in your PC. I am opening in this file. The name of the file is mysql-connector.jar file, and now it has been in zip folder. Now see, maine already isko kiya hai. When I double click it, now you will find this type of jar file has been available. तो मैंने इसको अनजिप किया है, ये वाली फाइल वो बन जाती है. दिस इज माई एसक्यूएल, और ये एग्जीक्यूटेबल जार फाइल है. साइज इज 529 KB. इसको आपको कॉपी करना है और आपके सी फाइल में जाना है, सी ड्राइव में, जहाँ पर भी आपका जावा इंस्टॉल है. सो सी फाइव माई प्रोग्राम जावा, डोंट गो इन टू JDK. JDK इज फॉर डेवलपमेंट, JRE इज फॉर सपोर्ट. गो इन टू JRE, गो इन टू लिब, गो इन टू एक्स्ट्रा एंड पेस्ट ओवर हियर. सो ऑलरेडी दैट इज देयर. So I will copy and replace it. So MySQL connector, I have already put it into that. So the path you have to keep in mind. So you have to put over here, okay? And it has already been shared with you that you have to put over here, okay? So put here. So मैं वो paste करता हूँ कि मैंने मेरे यहाँ पर वो paste कर दिए. कौन सी file? ये वाली file. Okay. And this is the one thing you have to do. Now भी MySQL जब भी आप use करते हैं, तो you can use directly MySQL setup. आप ये जो मैंने बोला था डीव के, ये वेबसाइट है developer.mysql. ये वेबसाइट पे जाके आप जावा का कौन सा भी वर्जन आप डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं. बट मैं हमेशा प्रेफर करता हूँ, बिकॉज ये बहुत सारे वर्जन्स होते हैं. दैट इंस्टॉलर आप उसमें जाके इंस्टॉलर यूज़ कर सकते हैं, 32/64 ये इंस्टॉलर यूज़ करो, और उसके बाद वो आपको डाउनलोड कर सकते. और सेकेंड वे इज़ ऑल्सो देयर, दैट इज़ यू कैन डाउनलोड यूजिंग अ ज़ैम्प ऑल्सो. सो अगर आप PHP यूज़ करना चाहते या फिर नहीं चाहते होंगे, बट यू कैन गो फॉर XAMPP ऑल्सो. सो यू कैन डाउनलोड अ XAMPP ऑल्सो. सो XAMPP इज़ ऑल्सो फ्रीली अवेलेबल ऑन इंटरनेट. you go anywhere and put XAMPP as that AM. XAMPP जो भी अगर 32 बिट का होगा तो आपको पीसी के लिए 32 बिट को क्लिक करो एंड दैट XAMPP विल बी डाउनलोडेड और उसको सिर्फ नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट करके इंस्टॉल करना है. सॉरी. सो यू कैन यूज डायरेक्टली यू कैन डाउनलोड MySQL और यू कैन डाउनलोड XAMPP बिकॉज XAMPP कंटेंस बाय डिफॉल्ट it contains MySQL. So if your PC is 64 bit, you can go for 64 bit, and for 32 bit also it is also available. You can search it on downloads and you can scroll it and you can get XAMPP of 32 bit also. So aap XAMPP bhi use kar sakte, up to you. To main aapko dikhata hu ki how this XAMPP after installing how it has been working. So agar ye XAMPP hai, whenever I am opening it, here at the bottom it will be open. So by default it is stopped. Now it is directly started. So मैंने इसको by default start करके रखा है. So I will check my Apache is started and MySQL is started. Port number is 3306. So अभी ये चालू है, इसका मतलब क्या, it is working. Okay. So मैं अभी क्या करता हूँ, इसको minimize कर देता हूँ and I am opening my browser. And in browser I am putting localhost. I am pressing enter. Now I will show you how to create a database and how to write a program for displaying it on a screen. So hamare paas time bhi bahut hai. Okay, now here localhost, because abhi ye maine install kiya to mere pc ke upar abhi ye open hai. I will go for my php myadmin. Step likh ke lo. Yes, am I ready? Okay. PHP myadmin ko. Wait, it will take some time. Okay. Now this here, as already I have seen that my database and Apache both are started, so MySQL is already started. Now when you open like this, the screen will be visible in front of you. Now you will be creating, because I have multiple database into this. But now I want to create a separate database. So main yahan par sabse pehle database ko click karunga. So I will click here a database. I want to give it name as MCA2. So main usko lower case mein hi naam deta, because database name are always being taken into lower case. So I will create a database called as MCA2. ऐसे मैंने नाम दिया एंड आई एम क्रिएटिंग दैट डेटाबेस. सो MCA2 डेटाबेस क्रिएटेड. ओके, नाउ सी दिस MCA2 इज बीइंग क्रिएटेड. सो हम ऑटोमेटिकली इसके अंदर आ चुके हैं, बिकॉज व्हेन आई क्लिक ऑन दिस, सो इट विल से क्रिएट टेबल. सो आई वांट टू क्रिएट अ टेबल कॉल्ड एज स्टूडेंट. सो मैं इसको लोअर केस में लिखता हूँ, बिकॉज अपर केस इज नॉट अलाउड हियर. अलाउड यानी आप ले डाल सकते हैं, बट इट विल नेवर हेल्प यू. सो आई विल राइट अ टेबल कॉल्ड एज अ स्टूडेंट टेबल. ओके, स्टूडेंट. तो मुझे उसके अंदर कितने फील्ड चाहिए, मेरे को चार चाहिए. सो आई विल गो फॉर ओनली फोर फील्ड्स. ओके, लेट इट बी फोर फील्ड्स को जाएंगे एंड आई प्रेस अ गो बटन. ओके, नाउ फर्स्ट स्टेप आई हैव क्रिएटेड डेटाबेस, सेकंड स्टेप आई हैव क्रिएटेड अ टेबल एंड द फील्ड्स आर अवेलेबल इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. सो द नेम ऑफ माय टेबल इज स्टूडेंट. नाउ दिस इज फर्स्ट फील्ड. आई वांट ऐड अ रोल नंबर. सो आई विल कॉल इट एज रोल नंबर. उसका टाइप क्या चाहिए मुझे, इंटीजर लेना है और उसको प्राइमरी की असाइन करना है. सर एट द राइट टाइम इट इज इंडेक्स. सो वैल्यूज कितने लेना है, अगर मुझे रोल नंबर चाहिए तो इट शुड एक्सेप्ट ओनली सपोज 3-digit नंबर. डिफॉल्ट को कोई जरूरत नहीं, कोलेशन एट्रीब्यूट भी कोई जरूरत नहीं एंड आई वॉन्ट टू मेक इट प्राइमरी की. देन आई वॉन्ट टू, सो गो से गो, नो प्रॉब्लम. देन आई वॉन्ट टू से एस नेम. So S name is a name of student. So it should be varchar. और मुझे 25 strength length ही लेना है और यहाँ पर मुझे कुछ करने की ज़रूरत है. सेम वे आई वॉन्ट टू टेक हिज कॉल एज अ कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर. सो कॉन्टैक्ट और एंड अगेन इट शुड बी स्ट्रिंग दैट इज कैर varchar एंड आई वॉन्ट टू मेक अ साइज ऑफ 10 ओनली. सो आई वॉन्ट टू एक्सेप्ट ओनली 10 ओनली, दैट इज ओनली. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू टेक एन एड्रेस. And again, it is a varchar because character and address can be of 50 size. So at the most, I will allow for 50 size. And at the end, I will say save. Now you see, in MCA2, the student will be available. और मैं इसको क्लिक करता हूँ, आई विल गेट अ कॉलम्स एंड लाइक दिस. और मैं इसको राइट क्लिक करता हूँ, कॉलम को मैं क्लिक करने के बाद मैं बोलता हूँ अभी न्यू नेम कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर एंड एस नेम एवरीथिंग इज एडेड. सो मैं अगर न्यू को क्लिक कर देता हूँ तो देर इज नो न्यू, आई डोंट वॉन्ट एनी न्यू. सो मैं एक स्टूडेंट को क्लिक कर देता हूँ तो इट विल शो मी देर इज़ नो रिकॉर्ड इन टू दिस बिकॉज द क्वेरी इज फायर सिलेक्ट स्टार फ्रॉम स्टूडेंट. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू एड समथिंग इन टू दिस, सो आई विल बी गोइंग फॉर इंसर्ट. सो फर्स्ट रिकॉर्ड आई वॉन्ट टू एड, दिस इज रोल नंबर 1, आई वॉन्ट टू एड सचिन एंड मोबाइल नंबर पुणे एंड से गो. वन रिकॉर्ड इंसर्टेड, ओके वन रो इंसर्टेड एंड आई कैन ब्राउज इट व्हेन आई क्लिक ऑन ब्राउज. तो वन देखो सचिन ऑन रिकॉर्ड इज बीन इंसर्टेड. अगर मुझे दूसरा रिकॉर्ड इंसर्ट करना है, आई विल क्लिक ऑन इंसर्ट. आई विल इंसर्ट 2 राजू कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर एंड मुंबई, सेम वे आई विल पुट गो. नाउ सी द क्वेरी हाउ इट इज बीन रिटन, इट इज वेरी सिस्टमैटिक. आप उसको क्वेरी को भी यूज कर सकते एंड आई कैन क्लिक ब्राउज ऑल्सो. देखो सेकेंड रिकॉर्ड इंसर्टेड. I want to record insert third record. I have already entered into that, so it is becoming very simple for me. I am not wasting your time. Okay, third record inserted. I can browse it and I can see that my third record is again inserted. I want to insert my fourth record. I will manually be dikhata hu ki kaise maine isko store kiya hai. So I will enter rule number 4. Now it is Rohit. And his mobile number, I will put it like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 digits I have entered and I will put it from Ahmednagar. Okay, and I put on go button. So whenever I browse this, I will find that my 4 records are been available in front of me. Okay, you can go for edit, you can go for delete, you can do directly from your database. Now the name of my table is student. And my name of my database is MCA2. So I must be very much specific about my name of my database, name of my table, and what all fields are there. So there is a role number, name, contact, and address. Are you clear up till now? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Now I will go into my programming language. Now one step I have done, what I have done, I have copied that connection file, that what I have specified. ये जो फाइल है मैंने ये वाली फाइल उसको कॉपी किया है, उसको डाउनलोड किया है, इज ए सेपरेट फाइल, और उसको मैंने यहाँ पर पेस्ट किया. मैंने आई हैव ऑलरेडी शोन यू दैट आई एम प्रोग्राम फाइल जावा JRE और लिप फोल्डर के अंदर इसको पेस्ट किया. सो अभी मुझे मेरा ड्राइवर जो लगने वाले है जावा को यूज़ करने के लिए, ऑल आर बीन रिटर्न इन टू दिस जार फाइल. सो माई इशू इज नाउ कम्प्लीटेड. नाउ वॉट आई विल डू इज दैट आई विल क्रिएट अ सेपरेट प्रोजेक्ट ओवर हियर. आई विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम स्क्रैप. सो आई एम यूजिंग फाइल New. I am creating a Java project. So project. Now this is I want to use a Java. So Java project. Next. I will give it MCA. Suppose database connectivity. So database. मैं उसको नाम देता हूँ database. Demo. So database demo is the name of my project. I will put a next. As it is version 1.8, so it will not support me type 1 driver because it is nowadays it has been outdated. So my folder of source will be created. I am putting a finish button over there. So if you by default, if you by chance, if you go for open perspective, तो ये थोड़ा सा गलत हो जाएगा, यानी आपके सामने देखो मैंने अगर मैं गलती से वो प्रेस किया, अगर इफ आई से नो देखो ऐसा स्क्रीन दिखाई देगा, और मैं क्लोज करूँगा तो मेरे मुझे ऐसा दिखाई देगा, ये कुछ नहीं स्क्रीन पे सिर्फ येल्लो कलर दिखाई देगा। सो मैं इसको थोड़ा क्लोज कर देता हूँ, ऐसा कुछ दिखाया। आप बोलेंगे सर प्रोजेक्ट कहाँ पर गया, सो हियर देयर इज़ अ पर्सपेक्टिव, सो दिस इज द जावा, सो नाउ आई विल गो फॉर जे डबल ई। No, now whenever this perspective is there, you will find that your project is being created, your database. Now source. Now in this source, I will create new file. New class. मैं बोलता हूँ student display. So I want to display something on my screen. So I मुझे उसके अंदर main function भी चाहिए. So I will finish. So automatic the skeleton will be used. Okay, so I want to do database programming. So import java dot sql dot star. I'm saving this. And now in main function, I will write something. So in this program, I want to use a connection class. So connection con object is equal to null. I want to use statement stmt, ऐसे मैं उसको नाम देता हूँ, statement is equal to null, और मैं select की query fire करने वाला, इसके वजह से मुझे चाहिए result set। अगर मेरी insert की query होती so तो मैंने उसको कुछ नहीं किया होता, so is equal to null, तो सब initialize मैंने कर दिए। अभी मेरा main program में अभी that is in main function I will do my connectivity, so whenever I am doing some connectivity I have to write some try catch. I need to write some try catch. So मैं catch भी लिखूँगा और catch किस चीज़ का है वो भी हम बाद में बात करेंगे. So in this now the step number one, जैसे हमने यहाँ पर मैंने बोला था कि हम step wise जाएंगे, ये मैंने PPT में डील दिखाया है क्योंकि हम अभी मैं आपके सामने प्रोग्राम कर रहा हूँ, सो मुझे ख्याल से कोई दिक्कत नहीं आनी चाहिए. तो स्टेप वाइज कहाँ पर, हाँ स्टेप नंबर वन इन्होंने बोला है कि यू कैन यूज़ दिस क्लास डॉट फॉर नेम. हाँ अब मुझे ये यूज़ करना है ओरेकल का. ओके तो मैं क्या करता हूँ, इसको कॉपी करता हूँ क्योंकि मुझे माई स्कूल के साथ ही कनेक्टिविटी करना है. सो मैं आई विल कॉपी द सेम सिंटैक्स. ओके इट इज़ टेकिंग सम टाइम. ओके इट इज स्लो, सो आई विल राइट दिस लाइक दिस. सो वेन एवर दिस टाइप ऑफ थिंग्स यू आर यूजिंग यू हैव टू हैंडल दिस कैच. सो वट इज दिस क्लास एक्सेप्शन, दैट इज क्लास नॉट फाउंड एक्सेप्शन, ये मुझे यूज करनी ही पड़ेंगे. सो whenever I am using this class dot for name I have to use this function. So class not found exception, so the name of this object is, suppose we call it as ex, and I need to handle this. So system dot out dot print ln, it is somewhat hanging. Wait dot out dot print. That is ex dot get message. अभी मेरा ये काम हो गया, अब मैं चेक करूँगा कि ये मेरा काम सही तरीके से हुआ कि नहीं. सो आई विल शो माई मैसेज समवेयर लाइक दिस, दैट इज स्टेप वन कंप्लीटेड. सो स्टेप वन कंप्लीटेड, मैं देखता हूँ अगर फेलियर हुआ तो विल शो सम एरर, अब मैं इसको रन कर देता हूँ. नाउ दिस इज माई स्टेप नंबर वन. यहाँ पर मैं नाम देता हूँ उसको स्टेप वन. स्टेप वन. सो मैंने सिर्फ एक सिंटेक्स लिखा है बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू डू कनेक्ट विद माई माई एसक्यूएल, और मैंने उसका करस्पॉन्डिंग कैच लिखा है, और अगर हुआ तो ये मुझे डिस्प्ले होना चाहिए. माई स्टेप वन इज कम्प्लीट. सो मैं राइट क्लिक करता हूँ एंड आई एम रनिंग दिस वन. इफ देर देर इज एन एरर इट विल शो मी एन एक्सेप्शन लाइक दिस. नाउ स्टेप वन इज कम्प्लीट, यानी उसको ये ड्राइवर मिल चुका है बिकॉज मैंने वो कॉपी करके पेस्ट करके डाला है. अगर मैं गलती से मैं आई विल शो यू, अगर मैंने इसको निकाल दिया, इफ आई डोंट पेस्ट दैट फाइल दैट इज जार फाइल इन टू माई डेटा बेस, सो वॉट विल हैपन, वट टाइप ऑफ एरर इट विल बी शोइंग टू मी. क्या सिस्टम सी ड्राइव. आई हैव पुटेड इट इन टू माई प्रोग्राम फाइल जावा जे आर ई लाइब्रेरी एक्स्ट्रा, और मैं क्या करता हूँ इसको डिलीट कर देता हूँ. MySQL.connect को डिलीट कर देता हूँ. अब ये नहीं है, मिनिमाइज करता हूँ. अब यही प्रोग्राम को मैं रन कर रहा हूँ. इट विल शो मी एन एरर दैट इज com.sql.gdbc ड्राइवर, ये उसको मिल रहा है, नहीं मिल रहा है, इसके वजह से उसने वो एरर दिखा बिकॉज दिस एक्सेप्शन बिन हैंडल. अब मैं क्या करता हूँ, वही फाइल को रिस्टोर करता हूँ फ्रॉम योर माई डाउनलोड्स. तो जैसे डाउनलोड्स में जाता हूँ, ये वाली फाइल है, इसको कॉपी करता हूँ, यहाँ पर आकर मैं पेस्ट करता हूँ. कहाँ पर पेस्ट की मैंने वो फाइल, mysql.jre फाइल. आई हैव पेस्टेड इन सी प्रोग्राम जावा jre lib एंड ई एक्स्ट्रा फाइल, इस फोल्डर के अंदर में डाल दी और मैंने इसको बंद कर दिया. एंड व्हेन आई रन दिस प्रोग्राम अगेन, नाउ दिस एरर इज नॉट बीन शोन बिकॉज नाउ इट इज फाइंडिंग दैट. ओके, नाउ अभी मैं क्या करता हूँ, आई विल नॉट वेस्ट माई टाइम. डेमो MC2 मैं क्या करता हूँ, डेटाबेस का एक प्रोग्राम मैंने ऑलरेडी लिखा है, उसमें से कुछ चीज़ों को मैं यूज़ करता हूँ मेरे प्रोग्राम के अंदर. तो यहाँ तक का काम खत्म हो चुका है. नाउ आई विल गो फॉर स्टेप नंबर टू. नाउ दिस इज स्टेप नंबर टू. स्टेप नंबर टू में क्या बोला है हमारे प्रेजेंटेशन में, कि उन्होंने बोला है कि आपको एक काम करना पड़ेगा, यूज़ गेट कनेक्शन दैट इज ड्राइवर मैनेजर डॉट गेट कनेक्शन, और ये आपको यूज़ करना है बिकॉज ये पाथ है. अभी मेरा यहाँ पर डाटाबेस का नाम अलग है. नाउ सी व्हाट स्टेप नंबर टू हैव डन. दिस इज कॉन, माई नेम ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट इज कॉन, सो आई विल बी यूजिंग एट कॉन con. माई नेम ऑफ माई स्टेटमेंट इज stmt, सो मैं यहाँ पर ये नाम करता हूँ stmt. The name of my result set object is RST, so I will be using the object code as RST. अभी ये ध्यान में मत लाओ कि हमने इसको कैसे किया है, हम स्टेप बाय स्टेप उसको जाएंगे, देन विल गो फॉर आउटपुट. स्टेप नंबर टू, आई एम यूजिंग कनेक्शन कॉन इज इक्वल टू, यहाँ पर मेरा एक एरर ये रहा. One step. इसको थोड़ा बढ़ाता हूँ. ओके, नाउ हियर व्हाट आई हैव डन इज दैट आई विल बी यूजिंग ड्राइवर मैनेजर डॉट गेट कनेक्शन. नाउ इट इज आई वांट डू माय एसक्यूएल, सो जीडीबीसी कोलन माय एसक्यूएल कोलन लोकल होस्ट, अप टिल हियर द स्ट्रिंग विल बी रिमेन एज इट इज. नाउ हियर आई हैव टू गिव द नेम ऑफ माय डेटाबेस, So as I have, you will see in your database, I have given a name of my database as MCA2, I think so. What name I have given to the database? See, the name of my database MCA2. And here it is also been written. So database MCA2 is my name being given to the database. So I will be giving name as MCA2 as a database. Now by default, when we go for MySQL, the username is root, and I have not given by default any password to that. So my password field is empty. So I cannot give a space also there. So no space, it is just a two quotes and that's it. So the whole string that you will be accessing my database through port number 3306, and the name of my database is MCA2. It will be opened with some root and root like that. Now statement, now this is connection. So now this connection is ready with opening your database. So connection task is completed. Now I'm creating a statement object that is STMT using that connection. So connecting to this database with some specific statement. So create statement. This is step number 3 I have created. And this will be displayed on a screen. So I have put it system.out.println. So I am writing some query. That is, I have written select star from student. So I have written a query called as a select star from student. And now, as it is a select query, so there is no need to write a double quote also. So let it. So as it is a select query, so I am using a function called as execute query. And this query that is select star from student, you can paste it here directly also, no issue. But here what is a systematic way? That you need to write it in a variable. So I have written it in a variable and I have passed it to the execute query because it is a select statement. It is not update. So it is execute query. And after that, it will be retrieving all the records, and for that purpose, a buffer is being provided. So the name of my buffer is result set. So what is RST? RST is nothing but a result set. And how to retrieve, navigate this result set? It is a result set dot next. If there is something into that result set, that will be displayed. So I want to display roll number, I want to display a name, I want to display contact number, and I want to display address. So I am concatenating that result set. That is, first variable is integer, so get int. Second variable is name, that is in string, so get string. Third, I have put it contact number in a string format, that is varchar. So get string third column and get string fourth column. So column number 1 will be my roll number because I need to know the design of my database. Agar mujhe mere database ki design pata, because roll number, name, contact and address. And when you go talk about roll number, it is nothing but an integer. Here it is nothing but a string. Here it is nothing but the string and again an address 4. So there are only 4 parameters. We'll start with 0, 1, 2 and 3. So that's it. So sorry, it is always column number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So column number 1, column number 2, 3 and 4. So we have retrieved and we have displayed in front of it. The name of my table is again student, and I have connected to my DB2, and the username is root and password I have not used in my database. So that's it. It's a very simple program. And finally, I can use that catch statement. That is, I have not closed that connection. So what I have to do is that I have to write something into finally also. So finally, I can write something that it, I need to write in a try catch block again. So try block and a catch with some exception, that is SQL exception. So I will not write anything into this. Now I will be closing whatsoever I have used into this program. So I want to use stmt dot close, then connection dot close. So I have closed this, and I will put it in a very justified way. So source, and I'm making format, so it will be very systematic whenever we read it. So see, step number 1 I have completed, step number 2 I have completed, and step number 3 will be using executing this statement, that is nothing but this is step number 3, and step number 4 will be retrieving something using, so this is step number 4. And finally, I'm closing everything. So there is nothing but a step number 5. So in finally block, I will be doing my closing operations of all the things what I have opened in your programming. So and this is one thing I have done, and I have saved this program, I will run this program. So run Java application. Step one completed. See, it will take time because this is the first time getting connected to the database. So we'll find that is first I have added with Sachin. Now see, step one completed, and I have completed displayed this record in front of you. All records are been displayed in front of you. So is everyone clear with this type of how to retrieve this content from a database? Yes, anyone, any issue, any problem? I have shown you how to create a table, how to create a database, and how to retrieve it into your program. Yes, sabko samajh mein aaya ye?
Yes sir.
Any difficulty? Yes. Yes, any difficulty? Anyone unmute?
No sir.
ऋषिकेश जमल आलिम, आया आपको समझ में?
यस सर, समझे।
अश्विनी, नाउ टाइप वन ड्राइवर्स आर नॉट
टाइप वन ड्राइवर्स आर नॉट
नाउ यू हैव टू डू
नाउ यू हैव टू डू
यस सो शैल वी स्टॉप टुडे शंकर आज नवीन आला वाटते तू शंकर
हो सर
का बरं
हो सर
इतके दिवस
का बरं इतके दिवस कुठे होता
काय नाही सर असंच
ओके सो इफ यू फाइंड एनी प्रॉब्लम
सो इफ यू फाइंड एनी प्रॉब्लम यू कैन
शंकर अनम्यूट
शंकर अनम्यूट
कर आरती एनी प्रॉब्लम आरती वांट टू आस्क एनीथिंग इशिता अश्विनी जयश्री
नो सर नो सर
सबको समझ में आया इशिता
यस सर
अगर आपको कोई दिक्कत है तो यू कैन री फिर से एक बार ना क्या कैसा उसको रिकैप करो कि मेरे वीडियोस जो है उसको एक बार रिकैप करके आप देख सकते हैं हमने स्टेप बाय स्टेप आपके सामने कोड लिखा है फॉर डिस्प्लेइंग रिकॉर्ड फ्रॉम डेटाबेस वेरी सिंपली आई हैव रिटन ओके सो विल मीट टुमारो विल बी डूइंग टुमारो अ प्रोग्राम ऑफ इंसर्टिंग एंड अपडेटिंग एंड डिलीटिंग अ रिकॉर्ड फ्रॉम अ डेटाबेस ऑन अ सेम स्टूडेंट टेबल एंड विल गो फॉर लॉग इन ऑल्सो सो हाउ टू चेक योर ऑथेंटिसिटी ऑफ अ लॉग इन यूजिंग कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट एंड यू कैन क्रिएट वंडरफुल एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ जी यू आई विद दिस वन बिकॉज इट विल टेक वेरी मच टाइम बिकॉज एट इनिशियल स्टेज जब तक आप वो आई डी के साथ फैमिलियर नहीं होते तब तक आपको समझ में नहीं आएगा बट मैंने भी एक चीज़ की थी आई हैव इंस्टॉल वन मोर थिंग्स दैट इज मेरे ख्याल से क्या है वो नहीं बट आपको यहाँ पर जी यू आई ऑलरेडी है अगर ज़ैम्प लिया तो इट बिकम्स वेरी सिंपल पर मैं यहाँ पर बहुत बार ये भी यूज़ करता हूँ दैट इज नथिंग बट One second, I will show you. C drive, MySQL program file के अंदर है, MySQL, workbench, it is work. Now ये भी मैंने workbench install करके रखा है, यानी ये जो GUI effect है, बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि when you go for GUI effect like this, ये वाला effect. ये वर्क बेंच से भी अप्लाई कर सकते हैं बहुत बार स्टूडेंट को क्या होता है कि सिर्फ MySQL डाउनलोड करते और उसको इंस्टॉल कर देते सो यू कैन डाउनलोड ओनली MySQL एंड यू कैन यूज़ दैट वर्क बेंच ऑल्सो नो इशू तो वर्क बेंच इज सेम लाइक योर MySQL मैं दिखाता हूँ वर्क बेंच कैसा है वर्क बेंच भी आप डायरेक्टली डाउनलोड कर सकते ये वर्क बेंच और उसको आप इंस्टॉल कर लो सो एक बार ओपन नहीं हो रहा एक मिनट सो वर्क बेंच 6.13 आई एम ओपनिंग इट if you are installing only MySQL use workbench because that will be having some GUI in front of you so main stop karta hu only as far as theory is concerned, only one thing is remaining, that is connection pooling. And now we'll be focusing only on the question paper, jo bhi questions university puchte uske upar hi hum focus karenge, and then we'll complete this chapter as early as possible. In the next week the chapter will be completed, and then we'll be entering into another type of program. But yahan par I am expecting that this benchmark is open. Let it be. It will take some time because it is heavy software that will be integrated with. Now see, is it visible in front for everybody? Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, whenever the home page is open, I have already closed that database. See, when I have closed everything, but it is not started. MySQL. आगे बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि सर बच्चे MySQL ही डालते हैं. सो उसको वर्चुअली GUI दैट इज ग्राफिकली आप उसको कैसे एक्सेस करते हैं, बिकॉज बहुत बार क्या होता है उसको DOS prompt से एक्सेस करना पड़ता है. सो यू कैन यूज दिस. सो माई द यूजर नेम इज रूट बिकॉज यू आर टेलिंग मी आई हैव नॉट एडेड एनी पासवर्ड टू दैट एंड यूज द लोकल होस्ट कोड 3306. सो व्हेन आई क्लिक ऑन दिस सो इट विल आस्क यू मी एंड इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली ओपन माई डेटाबेस. वेट, it is taking. Okay, see, it is somewhat heavy application. It is not connected, see. But when I start this one, MySQL, and I restart it. Let's see. Here I have to start manually. Continue anyway, because this is a third party being connected, and you will see all my tables that I have created. So I have created MC2 and to that table. You click on student and you click on this button and you will find your query is there, and you will find all records that I have added over there. All records are available in front of me. So ye maine jo tables banaya tha. So see, first one is Sachin, Raju, Vijay and Rohit. Mobile numbers are same because it is accessing the same table. Same. So if you have installed only MySQL, then you can use this workbench of MySQL that will be providing you a GUI, and you can fire any query and you can execute anything. If you want to read something like on benchmark, you can Google it on YouTube and you can get it from that also. But it becomes very difficult because you can add record directly here also. So if I want to add a fifth record, so fifth, suppose Anil, and this is mobile number, something like this, and it is Nashik, and you press just enter, or so you said some only here you need to put apply. So when you said apply,